My name is Stanislaw Rapper Liberto with AV Ultra, and in this quick tip, we're going to be talking about the favorites menu in Apple Motion. One of the drawbacks that people have complained about in Apple Motion is there's no good way to open up one composition inside another one. What I can do is I can copy and paste pieces of different compositions while they're both open and plop them in there. But what if I wanted something from another project from, let's say, months ago, and I may not remember what those are? That's what our favorites menu is for. What I've done here is I have this waypoint that I really like. I like the way it kind of animates on and pops onto my scene. And I have a floor with some nice reflection that I have that I want to be able to put somewhere else. If we come to my third area here, you can see I've got my waypoint and my floor right here. So you can see I've got the same kind of reflection, and I just have my waypoint animation separated out from everything else. If I go into my library, you can see there is a floor and there is a waypoint. And what this will do is it lets me save out copies of any kind of pieces of my compositions to be able to access them quick and easy. As an example, I'm in my map demo that we've talked about before in lesson 26, and I want just this waypoint with this flag and this text coming in. So I'm gonna move on down to my waypoints, and I'm going to solo by holding on to Alt Option and click on my layer. And what I'm gonna do with this guy right now is I'm just gonna make sure that he is zeroed out. The reason for that is when I'm going to be putting this into another group, I want to be able to have it zeroed out. So now that I have this, I'm going to grab this waypoint. We're going to go to our favorites menu, and I'm going to create a new folder, and I'm just going to call this folder demo flags. And I'm going to grab this waypoint one and just toss them in there. And I'm going to close out that composition. I'm in a favorites composition where I just dragged in a new floor. And if I go to my favorites menu and I grab my demo flags, there's my waypoint one. If I drag this into my composition and I play this back, I can see there it is animating exactly the way I want to. So this is a great time saver if I have reusable assets that want to go from project to project. Let's take a look at one more quick example. I have another composition that I have open, and in this composition, I've created this kind of undulating, wavy movement for a background. And maybe I really like the way I put this guy together. Maybe I'm not too crazy about this color, but I just want these cloud generators in this circle format to be transferred over to something else. Because this is a generator that has a bunch of different effects on it, I can still save all of these different items to my favorites menu. So if I grab this clouds and I drag him into my favorites menu, he's gonna be in there as well too. One thing to note about your favorites menu is it'll give you an idea of what you're looking at. Our clouds are based on a generator. That floor was based on a shape, and my waypoint was a group. So that's why it looks a little bit more like that. One caveat about these is you can't access any of these favorites on a different machine. If I right click this and I reveal this in the Finder, I can see that this is actually on my Macintosh HD application support motion library favorites, and it will make it a MOLO, a motion library object. So be aware of that when you're working with different computers. Otherwise, this is a great way to create a repository of different items so that way you can put together different projects very quickly and easily. Thanks a lot for watching. I'll see you next time.